All right, thanks, Kristen. And speaking of horses, we're going to send things south to Ruidoso, where Chad is standing by at the Ruidoso Downs with one of the most celebrated jockeys in the business. Good morning, Chad. Who are you hanging out with this morning?
Yeah, that's right, Fernanda. Good morning. I am here with G.R. Carter Jr. He is an insane, one of the most celebrated, one of the most victorious. This guy has had 29,000 races in your career.
Yeah, I've ridden a total of over 29,000, including all breeds, like 24,000 quarter horse races, 3,000 or 4,000 paints, and about 3,000 thoroughbred races.
Wow.
Yeah.
With a career like that, absolutely, yeah. One would say, okay, I'm going to retire happily, which you did retire, but you're coming out of retirement today for this race. What is bringing you out of retirement?
Well, I've been riding for 30 years, and I retired back in December, but I'll tell you what brought me out of retirement is the All-American.
Okay.
You know, the All-American is, it's the marquee. It's the Kentucky Derby, the Super Bowl. It's the biggest thing. It's the biggest thing in quarter horse racing. And New Mexico is really, really fortunate to have this race here in the state. And it's a big part of New Mexico. And this race has a history all the way back to 1959. It has been the marquee race in quarter horse racing since the very inception of it back in 59. And had an opportunity to ride the All-American, and there's no way I could say no.
And you're also on a pretty great horse here. Looking at this, you're going to be riding Cool and Famous this afternoon. Now, his father, he's sired from a horse that has three of his other horses in this race. Yeah. So you've got a good breed that you're riding today.
Yeah, the horse I'm riding is by the good sire, One Famous Eagle. And One Famous Eagle has four of the 10 finalists of the All-American, which is just unheard of. So They seem to have an affinity for the 440-yard distance that we're running today, and I'm really excited about it and looking forward to it. And I'm like a kid in a candy store again at 48 years old.
That's amazing. So out of all of these races that you've done, thousands of victories, you get 4,000 victories to your credit there. Plus, what is the one thing that keeps you coming back?
The thrill of winning just never gets old, you know, especially in these bigger races, you know, even if it's from a small race to an old race, winning never gets old. And it's that rush that you get from crossing that finish line in front and beating those other horses. There's nothing like it, you know.
Now, how much of it, when you're on that horse and you're in the zone and watching, being here firsthand, seeing how fast these horses are going, are you using your peripheral vision? How aware are you of where you stand with your competitors?
You know, you're very aware of whether you're in front or not, because quarter horse racing is just like a drag race. It's all about straight to the point, and getting that burst of speed. And so you need to really get your horse away from the gate really good. And you can see out of the corners of eyes you're in front of the other horses if there's something just off your shoulder and all. But you really don't want to. You don't really want to be glancing around. You want to be focusing on the horse that's underneath of you—that's actually the only one you can ride in the race.
Yeah, exactly. The only one you got control over.
It's the only one you got control of. So don't be worrying about the other ones. Just try to keep your horse doing what he can do and straighten to the point and keep him in front.
Now, I understand that you have when you win a big race, you have a bit of a ritual, I guess you could say, and it's kind of become famous, I guess, in the quarter horse world, which is the GR flip. Tell us about that.
Oh, I had a gymnastics background from like third to eighth grade. I went to gymnastics, actually competed for a Phillips 66 program out of Bartlesville, Oklahoma. And so I could do a backflip off of a horse fence, whatever. And it became kind of a trademark as some guys talked me into doing it off a racehorse. The first time I ever did it was in 1988 at Blue Ribbon Downs in Salisaw.
Wow.
After a big stakes victory, I'm more of a show off, you know. I think it's been good for the sport. It's drawn attention to quarter horse racing. Mm-hmm. They've got a lot of good press out of it. And as I got older, you know, I wanted to slow up on doing the backflip. And whenever I'd win a race, and I could just hear I'd jump off, and I could hear the kids standing on the rail, and I'm, oh, he didn't do it, you know. And that almost make me feel guilty enough, or I wanted to get back on and do it for him. But you know, at 48, if of course the one time that I might do it was if I was to win the All-American. It's the one that's gonna make you excited enough to want to do it. Maybe they can back him up to the pond or something. All right? The infield pond where I could have a little softer landing.
Yeah, I was gonna ask you. Do you think that we're gonna see that famous flip this afternoon? I guess we'll see.
We'll see some form of a backflip today if I win the All-American.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. GR. I know you got to get your head in the game right now. Thank you so much for your time this morning. Best of luck this afternoon. Have fun. So appreciate you coming out.
Thanks for having me, Chad. Absolutely. I really enjoy doing it.
Absolutely. All right, folks, before we head to break, though, it is time for your American Home Tip of the Day. Make it a weekend event. If you got a big event like the All-American Futurity going on, make it a weekend festivity. Book a hotel room, spend some time in the city, be a local. Now go plan your next adventure, and we'll be right back.